The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13040 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme, and I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister, and I call on Douglas Ross to move amendment 13040.1. Up to 5 minutes, please.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And the business of Parliament this week is fluid. Indeed, last night the business managers were presented with a proposal from the Scottish Government to debate and vote on two votes of no confidence, one in the Scottish Government and one lodged on my behalf lodged by me on behalf of the Scottish Conservatives as a vote of no confidence in Hamza Youssef. That one has been successful. Hamza Youssef is resigning as First Minister of Scotland. Therefore, I thought it was right to use the time that the Scottish Government had found for a debate in this Parliament, just 30 minutes, to get a statement from the Lord Advocate here in the Scottish Parliament on the current situation of her position and the Scottish Government's position on the Horizon scandal. And I think that is a crucially important issue that must be discussed and debated here in the Scottish Parliament. Now, that was put forward by my business manager at the Bureau, and that was rejected by the Scottish Government. I understand the Scottish Government would look to bring that forward at a later date, and I hope, even if this motion is not successful, they will do that. And I think it is important, and we decided to take this to the Chamber this afternoon. So these discussions are not held behind closed doors, that sub-postmasters across Scotland can see that MSPs, I think, across the political spectrum want answers on their behalf. So I am moving an amendment today, Presiding Officer, that would simply not delete any other business tomorrow, because the Government have come forward with another debate and there will be a vote of no confidence, but simply to say, instead of finishing at 5 o'clock tomorrow night, we stay for an extra 30 minutes till 5:30 to get the Lord Advocate in front of us, to make a statement to this Parliament and to the people of Scotland and to answer questions. Because across the chamber, there is a clear consensus that the wrong, where sub-postmasters were wrongly prosecuted because of a faulty IT system, must be resolved and resolved as quickly as possible. It's abundantly clear that there must be a blanket exoneration legislated for as soon as possible. But given the independent legal system, given the independent legal system we have here in Scotland, it is an entirely devolved matter for this Parliament, and the fastest way for a blanket exoneration to be taken forward is primary legislation here in the Scottish Parliament. And just before I give way to Keith Brown, this is where we come into an issue, because we've heard very positive comments from Scottish Government ministers that they want to do that, they want to legislate as quickly as possible, and we welcome that. But we've also had conflicting comments from the Lord Advocate, who serves not just as the head of the Crown Office and Procurator Fiscal Service in Scotland, but as a member of the Scottish Government, sitting round the Cabinet table. So until we know if her position has changed, or if it remains the same that she is against a blanket exoneration, we will be no further forward. And the reason why I think this is so important tomorrow, and I hope the business manager will accept this on behalf of the Scottish Government, is it was the 16th of January, that we last heard from the Lord Advocate. 3.5 months later, I think this Parliament, but more importantly sub-postmasters, deserve to know the current position of both the Lord Advocate and the Scottish Government. I will give way to Mr Brown.
Keith Brown.
Can I thank Mr Ross for giving way, and I think we are agreed on the fact that we want to see this happen as quickly as possible. Given the fact that this was activity undertaken by the Post Office, a reserve function, and overseen by the UK Government, doesn't he think the quickest way to do this would be for the UK Government to have incorporated the process at the UK level, where this started? And as he asked that question at Westminster, why can that not be the quickest, most effective, quickest way to do it? Surely he would support that, and is there any reason why he wouldn't support it?
Douglas Ross.
Well, not only have I asked that question, but I heard the responses yesterday from the Minister, Kevin Hollenrake, and indeed from MPs of all political persuasions, with the exception of the SNP. There was the Post Office Horizon System Offensive Bill passed in Westminster yesterday, which is why we need to know what's going to happen in Scotland, because the crucial difference is the prosecutions here in Scotland were led by the Crown Office, not by the Post Office as they were in England and Wales. Therefore, I think there is agreement. I hope there is agreement across this Parliament that, crucially, we need answers on behalf of the sub-postmasters. And I would simply ask, we are now in the era of a minority government where we have to work together. Surely it's in the interests of that fresh start and for this Parliament to be able to do its job that the government accepts that tomorrow night we stay for an extra 30 minutes until 5:30 at night to hear from the Lord Advocate, to get answers, and then we can move forward to bring in this important legislation. I move the motion in my name.
Thank you, and I call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau. Up to 5 minutes, Minister.
First and foremost, Presiding Officer, the people involved in the Horizon scandal are the ones that are the most important in this, because they have waited decades for Westminster to find a solution to this issue. But this is all very disappointing from the Conservatives, and I feel I have to educate Mr Ross in the way this Parliament works. He seems to be more au fait with how Westminster works. The Parliamentary Bureau was set up as a way where all parliamentary bodies, all parties who were part of members of it, could have the discussion on how business went forward. We have these open discussions. It's a safe place for everyone to have that discussion. It's not for us to sit here and kind of start chuntering on about it in the chamber 2 hours after the meeting. It's to be done there in the Bureau. And he's quite right. It's not behind smoke-filled rooms or anything like that. It's perfectly open for everyone to see. But the disappointing part and the misunderstanding is, during that debate discussion, I said, I have just received this information this morning. I have been to Cabinet. Things have been quite busy. I will get back to business managers in the usual manner. Now, surely we've built up enough trust with organised individuals to deal with that. But let's just deal with the clarity of the situation. There is no clarity needed. The Scottish Government has repeatedly made clear that their position that legislation will be brought forward to the Scottish Parliament is required. Late last night, it became clear that the UK Post Office Bill would not be extended to Scotland, and the Scottish Government are deeply disappointed with that decision made by the UK Government. The Scottish Government has always, we've heard enough, Mr Ross, the Scottish Government has always said we would bring forward a Scottish bill if that was the case. I wouldn't mind if Mr Ross had anything of any value to add to the debate. I normally, Presiding Officer, I normally respect the parliamentary process, but on this occasion, when the Tories are playing politics with people's lives, I can confirm that a bill is currently going through the usual parliamentary process and will be introduced shortly. With that in mind, people have waited years, if not decades, for the Westminster establishment to do something on this, but this Scottish Government will not let the postmasters down and will deliver.
The question is that Amendment 130.40.1 in the name of Douglas Ross, which seeks to amend Motion 130.40 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote. There'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.